Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. Thank you for being here. Volleyball Day in Nebraska. How awesome is that? What other athletic department in the country, late February, is doing a press conference to announce an outdoor volleyball game in August? That's how big volleyball is in the state of Nebraska. Actually, we all just got done celebrating 50 years of Title IX, and many of the athletic departments across the country, including those that are here with us here today, spent a lot of time focusing on women's athletics and the impact of Title IX on our athletic department. And I thought, what better way to celebrate Title IX than to celebrate volleyball in the state of Nebraska? Title IX has created a monster, the North Star of volleyball in the state of Nebraska. And what a great way to celebrate it by bringing everybody together. We've always believed that athletics at the University of Nebraska can be used to bring people together. So we're really proud to have schools from all across our state come to Memorial Stadium to celebrate the progress of Title IX in a women's sport like volleyball. And I do need to acknowledge that we hope that one of the outcomes of celebrating our volleyball programs in the state of Nebraska is that we, for once and for all, establish the all-time attendance record for volleyball nationally. Okay? As I said many months ago, the attendance record for volleyball belongs in the state of Nebraska. Started with a dare to our fans, and they stepped up and have been since 2001. I don't think any volleyball team even dreams about doing that. And again, I always say the epicenter of volleyball is right here in Nebraska.
Versus number 7, Nebraska Mantle Kevin.
What makes it so cool about being a Husker and coaching and playing for Nebraska, because it is such a big deal. Husker fans, Trent Alberts here, of course, with John Cook, our volleyball coach, on a beautiful day in Memorial Stadium. And, you know, Coach, we're about 4 months out now from Volleyball Day in Nebraska. It's going to be just a special day. And John and I just really need to say thank you. We've had over 82,000 people buy tickets to Volleyball Day in Nebraska. This place is going to be sold out. Coach, how do you define the kind of success and support that Husker Nation has given to your program?
Well, right now we're all having an out-of-body experience, because this just, you know, it's overwhelming to see what's happened the last 2 days. And I never really believed, as you know, I was doubtful. But when President Carter got up there and said, we're selling this thing out, I started believing then. And you know, you start thinking it, now it's happening. And I just seen the reactions are incredible.
Well, it really has been incredible. It's a real testament to you and your program and for what you stand for, the young ladies that are part of it. But we also should give a nod to the other participating schools and thank the fans of those schools for coming as well. This is going to be a celebration of women's athletics, a celebration of volleyball, and we just want to thank everybody for their focus. We recognize that over the last couple of days, there was such intense demand that our team did the very best they could to sort of keep up with that demand and continuing opening up new spots. And I want you to know that as we go through here, we still have more demand. I've asked our team, Coach, to do everything they possibly can. Let's look at every possible area we can open up. Let's bring as many fans in as we can get. I mean, this has blown us away, but we're gonna do everything we can to allow anybody who wants to be a part of this special day to be a part of it.
Yeah, I think that would be awesome, because I think there's more people that want to get in.
Well, John has assured me that the weather is going to be perfect. Light wind, no rain, and about 86 degrees.
Okay. Our players are going to be so pumped up with 80,000 here, it won't matter what the heck's going on.
Well, on behalf of John and I, the entire athletic department, our volleyball program, President Carter, we're just so grateful
for the support of Husker Nation and for volleyball fans all across Nebraska. We look forward to celebrating a very special day with you in about 4 months.
Volleyball Day in Nebraska.
We are going to make history here in the state of Nebraska.
The 30th day of August 2023 is Nebraska Volleyball Day.
And if any volleyball program can sell out a football stadium, it is Nebraska.
Inside Memorial Stadium. This is Volleyball Day.
Running along the fence lines.
A shared history of an uncommon legacy. Nebraska's 14th Final Four, they got four titles. That makes champions of girls from Cortland and Malcolm, Olympians of women from Papillion and Hupper. It outgrew the Coliseum, packed the Devaney Center, and set its eyes on the Sea of Red. Striking the ground like lightning.
To Jordan Larson. It's over.
And rattling the roof like thunder.
This is in the swing outside. Kelsey B. Go the grand kill.
Writing her legacy in tales of scarlet and gold.
Kayla Fackney. She did it. Nebraska wins its fifth national championship.
Welcome to the state of volleyball.
There is no place like Nebraska.
Thank you.
what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so
volleyball. Population 90,000.
Where records are shattered
and the standards sit as high as the banners. What Pat built, Puttett defined, and Cook perfected.
But we feel this is what we need to do to win a national championship.
That'll do it. Nebraska has won the national championship.
It's showtime in the Star City.
Pass the slide.
Big Red on the biggest stage.
Welcome, welcome.
Welcome to Memorial Stadium,
home of Nebraska volleyball.
Let's meet your Nebraska Cornhuskers! The North starter, a sophomore number 7, Macy Bosinger! A junior number 9, Kennedy Orr! A freshman number 10, Caroline Cherubishes! A sophomore number 11, Hayden Cubin! A junior number 14, Allie Batenhorn! A junior number 22, Lindsay Krause! And a sophomore number 44, Maggie Mendelson! And now the starting lineup for your Huskers! A 6'1 freshman out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota, number 2, Bergen Riley! A 6'4 and sophomore from Lincoln, Nebraska, number 5, Becca Allen! A 5'3 freshman out of Raleigh, North Carolina, number 6, Lady Chowboy! A 6'4 four-inch junior out of Carbondale, Alabama, number 13, Mara Bisa! A 6'3 freshman out of Brighton, Colorado, number 15, Andy Jackson! And a 6'2 freshman out of Ann Arbor, Michigan, number 27, Harper Murray! And your libero, a 5'5" junior out of Sterling, Illinois, number 8, Lexi Rodriguez! Junior Hunter, Mr. Costinger, Jordan Larson, Kelly Hunter, and Jalen Rand. The director of operations is Lindsay Peterson.
right, so I'll ask you, Emily, how do you come down from that, the crowd there on the court?
I think this is the moment where you have to do what everyone's been saying, just stay in the moment. Coach Cook has been leading that to his team. Yes, it's a show, massive festivities, but at the end of the day, once that pregame show and the festivities are done, we have a game to win right now. You have to stay level-headed and focus in on the scouting report and let it fly.
What John Cook said yesterday, right, is we've got all this stuff, we've got all these questions about the emotions of the moment. We've got an actual match that counts, even though it is outside with all this circumstance, against the team that took them to five sets, Omaha, 2 years ago. On a night where we're expecting to break the world record, off we go from Lincoln, Nebraska. Curry, the center for Omaha, and that's too strong, and Nebraska takes the first point. Just the fourth college match for Bergen Riley in front of this crowd. Murray goes to the pin, caught up in the block with Beeson. Harper Murray, the reigning freshman of the week in the Big Ten.
Harper Murray, known for her heavy arm. Sometimes she goes to that off-speed shot just right over those blockers, catches the defense off guard because they know that she can absolutely take a crack at it.
The adrenaline of the moment, you think maybe you try to smoke one deep. Calm and composed for the first year player, Murray. Murray back to the pin with the swipe in Omaha on the board with Shayla McCormick, an Omaha native.
One thing to watch as this game is just getting started is especially if some of those passes go high, the wind becomes a big factor. You know, can that setter get there in time to get completely square and put up a good ball? And can that hitter, if it's a high ball situation, actually put a good ball out of it?
The wind is at the back of Omaha right now. Picked up a little bit since first serve. Into the backcourt, Lexi Rodriguez, the libero for Nebraska. That's picked up on the overpass, and Murray swats it down. So I think Nebraskans woke up every day since February when it was announced this was happening, checked the weather app. Was it going to rain?
Connor,
I've
been checking the weather apps literally since February. You know, can that read all the way into September? I don't know, but we've been doing it, and beautiful forecast tonight. Zero clouds.
That's off hands and out in Omaha. Back within one. But we did learn that that was the thing, and then it became more about the shade and would there be some glare? Would you need any sunglasses tonight? Sun dipping down, none needed, just the winds.
The heat also thought about it being a factor in this game. It was 100 degrees last week. That's what they practiced in.
And Krause with the first ball for Nebraska. And Merritt Beeson turned back, covered by Murray. And Krause into the cross court. And Merritt Beeson at the service line for Nebraska. And overpass kill. Andy Jackson out of the middle.
That's why you gotta be in front. You gotta expect every single time this service ball is going over. Lindsey Krause, ready for it. Locked and loaded.
The pass takes Omaha off the net and tapped around the antenna for Jurgensmeyer. Rolled up and kept alive for Fava, the libero for Omaha. Riley picks out Murray.
The back row attack was a key focal point of this Nebraska offense, something that they worked on all spring, all preseason, to really establish as a threat, especially up the middle. With Harper Murray in the back row, can be lethal.
Transition
these easy plays, perfect pass, set right to the middle. Nice
kill. 1,000. Nebraska on a 4-0 run, forcing the Omaha timeout. Ivy Luke setting up for Omaha. Trickles over to Rodriguez. And the Cornhuskers, and that's rolled down for Krause, who's off to a good start tonight.
Nebraska's a team that's often just going to come shot. They're throwing in a lot of off speeds to start this match, really exploiting that middle of the court that Omaha's not going
to have. With that off speed, five in a row for the Cornhuskers, keeping Beeson back at the line. Keeping serve with the wind in her face. Over the top, Beeson recovers, and Riley gets a hand on it. Little crack back to the outside for Jorgensmeyer, and it's turned back.
Offense, these hustle plays, this is what makes them such a great defensive team. Those balls that you think are going to drop, they're able to scoop right under because they're stopped on defense and can make it a more inexperienced Omaha team.
A lot of friends here for her tonight. She's from Wahoo, Nebraska. The eight that Omaha has on the team from the state. Oh, and there's the opposite of the off-speed we've seen so far. Jackson getting them going.
Welcome to Lincoln, Andy Jackson.
And Laney Choboy in serving for Nebraska. And he's passed it on to 2 decades plus of John Cook. Several national championships later. And Nebraska's closing in on a world record breaking night sweep.
Nebraska getting back, even though they are up. Allie Badenhorst, beautiful swing. That middle blocker held with the other middle, as that was a perfect pass situation, and Badenhorst exploits that.
These players have been asked questions in so many different ways. How are you going to feel when you walk onto this court on August 30th? I thought Allie Badenhorst had a really leveled answer yesterday. There's an ace for Beeson. The answers, right, were phased. She said, joy. That's what I'm going to feel looking around.
Mayor Beeson, a player who has played at the highest crowds the NCAA has to offer. She's a player that's not going to shy down from this moment.
Oh, with the left hand along the tape, and Jorgensmeyer can't put it over. Nebraska 3 points away from a sweep.
Starting to get a little bit louder and louder, waiting to get on their feet for that set point. 92,000, three of them.
New world record here tonight, right here in Lincoln, Nebraska, Memorial Stadium. Rodriguez with the second ball for Badenhorst. Rattling through the block, Jorgensmeyer there. And that is out, and here comes match point number one. Participation from 92,003. Snapshots and moments tonight that these players, these fans will never forget. Rodriguez retreating. Badenhorst. Sent back over for Rook. Reload for Riley. And Mendelson puts it away for Nebraska.
Facebook.com. Nebraska Volleyball is powered by Maryland. Make sure to stay on your feet.
Well, Nebraska pulled this off. They win, but the headline of tonight will always be a world record going down. 92,003 fans see Nebraska sweep Omaha.
Thank all of you for being here. Thank you for setting a world record tonight. Nebraska has the best fan base in the world, the best volleyball fans in the world, and it's my pleasure and privilege now to introduce who I think is the best volleyball coach in the country, our own Mr. John Cook.
Thank you. As we say, we have the best fans in the country. You guys proved it. And I was thinking this morning, there's only three things that shut down the University of Nebraska. One, snowstorms. Two, COVID. Three, Nebraska Volleyball in the stadium! So students, you're welcome. And the last thing I'll say, I want to shout out to Kenny, who was firing everybody up, but from one of our players, she said, tonight, the impossible is possible. So thank you very much. There's no place like Nebraska.
You see it on their faces. Let's talk about this moment.
You're going to make me cry right now. I mean, this is unbelievable. For women's athletics to do this in Nebraska, you know, we've dreamed big here tonight. We really dreamed big. And again, I think Kennedy Ward wrote me a note today and said, Coach, tonight we'll do the impossible. It'll be possible. We do it. Our people did an unbelievable job setting the stadium up. I had no idea how much work goes into this. And they deserve a ton of credit. We got a great team here.
I know I asked this before, but when you said offhandedly, maybe we'll do it at Memorial Stadium, can you believe you're here at this point now?
No, I still can't. I feel like we're at a rock concert or something. And the fans are fired up tonight. I mean, this is a party. It's awesome.
It really is a celebration, not just of Nebraska volleyball, but volleyball in Nebraska.
I think so, and you gotta give credit to Nebraska Omaha and Wayne State and Kearney, but you're right, it's NAI, it's high school, it's club, it's Creighton. We got a lot of great volleyball in this state, and you're right, this was a celebration day for all the great players. It was so awesome seeing all the alumni here. I've never seen that many alumni before. It was unbelievable.
John, it doesn't happen without a vision. Congratulations on having the vision.
Thanks for Big Ten for being here.
The impossible. John Cook said it via Kennedy or the impossible, possible. And we've seen more emotion today from John Cook than maybe we've seen ever from him publicly.
John Cook normally is such a stoic figure, one of those people in sports that is always level-headed. Can't get him to cry easily, but 92,000 people in the stadium will do it.
How are you doing?
I'm tearing up over here, not gonna lie.
Well, this is a party. Drum show, players dancing near the end zone. With a concert to come. Play of the match, is that the last 10 minutes that we just witnessed? The fireworks drone show organized to show the number that set the world record tonight, 92,003 fans. And you talk about laying courts and all the logistics that went into this. This is an absolutely amazing cap. An incredible night.
Coach Cook said it best, they made the impossible possible. Making this match happen was one of the hardest things to do in college athletics, and they made it happen, and it turned out pretty dang good.
they're standing up on arms of Nebraskans throughout this amazing, iconic facility of Memorial Stadium. Nebraska getting a sweep all part of it as well, but about much, much more than that, the growth of women's sports, Husker volleyball, and sport of volleyball nationally. This is a perfect depiction of that tonight. Honored we got to experience this together tonight. 92,003. That is the world record in attendance to beat. And nobody has left as John Cook and the Huskers leave the court for the final time.